Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Last video, I talked about the ComfyUI native implementation of Hunyuan video. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the GGUF version. The GGUF are basically quantized version of the model, and you get things like this. So you will be able to use the 3-bit all the way to 16-bit, and we can use this chart here to understand what it means. So the 3-bit quantization is basically the lightweight version. It has the lowest precision. It's going to give you the lowest quality as well, but it should be the fastest out of all of them. And as you go down the list, you get higher precision. It's going to be more performant in terms of quality, but the downside is it's going to take more resources as well as more time. Now, a good balance would be the Q5 one. It gives you a good middle ground between performance and quality. Now, if you cannot run the Q5, you can always run the Q4. Worst case scenario, you will be able to run the Q3 version. And in case you're wondering, this is the GPU that I'm using. I have only 12 gigabytes of dedicated RAM, but I'm still able to run Hunyuan video on my system, both the native implementation and the quantized implementation. So in today's video, I'm going to do a comparison as well in terms of quality and speed. I'm going to show you the result of my testing. Now, first you will need to get the quantized version of the model. So go to the Hugging Face page, link will be in the description below, and then click on files and versions, and you will be able to download any of the versions that we have here. We have from Q3 until the Q8, and then we have the Q16 version at the top here. And here's a post of someone who shared their findings when they were trying the Q5 version on their RTX 3090, which has 24 gigabytes of VRAM. And for them, the model was using 19 gigabytes of VRAM, and it took 6 minutes per video. Now, for me, since I have only 12 gigabytes of VRAM, I'm still able to run the Q5 version, the same version that the other person mentioned, but it took me 8 minutes to generate a video. So even if you have less VRAM, you should be able to run it as long as you have the correct setup. I will show you how to set the workflow up so that it works on low VRAM card. And here are a couple of examples of what you will be able to generate. The actual resolution of these videos are 480p each one. Now, this is a fail, and I'll explain why a little bit later on. This one is pretty good, and I think this one is the best use case when it comes to this model. Now, I think this one came out really well. As you can see, we have a drone, and I asked for a drone flying on top of an abandoned village. And as you can see, we have all the elements, and it's really well done. If I had more VRAM, probably I could have tested at 720p, but unfortunately, I get out of memory issues. So 480p is the sweet spot for me. And this generation took 8 minutes. The native implementation of Hunyuan video takes around 14 minutes to generate a video. So I get about a 40% increase in speed. In terms of quality, both are pretty much the same. I cannot go to 720p even with the native implementation. So at least for me, on 12 gigabytes of VRAM, I don't see much of an improvement in terms of quality using the native version over the quantized version. In fact, the quantized version is better in my opinion, since I get that 40% speed boost. All right, let's talk about how to set it up on your system. So first, you will need to go into Manager, Custom Nodes. At the top here, search for GGUF, and you will need to install this custom node here, the ComfyUI GGUF. If you already have it from Flux, then you will need to update it. Otherwise, the Hunyuan version will not work. So update it or download the latest version and then restart your ComfyUI. Now, you can load this default workflow from ComfyUI examples page, or you can go into the description of this video. I will have the final workflow already available. But in case some of you are trying to build your own, trying to experiment, let me go through on how to set up the GGUF workflow. The main difference is you will need to get rid of this load diffusion model and then replace it with the GGUF unit loader. So simply click on it, delete, and you'll need to connect this unit loader GGUF with the model sampling SD3, and then we'll need to connect it with this basic scheduler. So make sure that both of these nodes are connected, and you will need to get one of these models from Hugging Face page. Now, in my case, I've tested the Q3 and the Q5, but you can always try the other versions as well. Once you have the model downloaded, you will need to move those models into ComfyUI models, and then scroll down until you see unit folder. Go inside and then paste those models file here. As you can see, I have the Q5 and Q3 version. Now, if you come back to ComfyUI, you will need to refresh. So you can press Control F5 to do a hard refresh and then go into Edit, Refresh Node Definitions. And you should be able to select it from the drop-down list here. Select the version that you'd like to use. And that's about it in terms of the workflow. Now, some of you in my previous video mentioned that they were not able to run the native version and it went through the sampler custom advanced, but they got an out of memory when it came to the VA decode. And in that video, I mentioned that you will need to decrease the tile size and overlap if that is the case. So for me, these are the settings which work, but if you have less than 12 gigabytes of VRAM, you may have to go lower. I also mentioned that you can always decrease the resolution of the video, the final output, in order to test that out. The same thing applies for the GGUF version. So if you are getting any out of memory issues after the sampler custom advanced node, then it's because your system is not able to decode the from latent space to pixel space, and it's not able to get those images. So make sure to decrease the VAE decode if that is the case. So for my testing, I've gone with this particular theme and I've tested a concept. Next, I have a sci-fi theme where we have a robotic hand hovering over a glowing panel in a dim lit spaceship. Now, this one was a failed attempt. It's the fantasy theme where I've asked for a knight drawing a glowing sword from stone in the middle of moonlit clearing. And I think it's because the movement of drawing the sword is too complex. So that is why we can see clipping happening. Next one is an urban theme. And I think this one came out really well. We have a street musician with an old guitar seated on a graffiti covered sidewalk. And we can see all the elements, including people in the background. They are slightly blurry, saying that they are in the background. We have the graffiti on the wall as well. Lastly, I've tested a concept. So atmospheric concept where we have a candle flickers on a wooden table in a dark, empty room. Then we have shadows on the wall. As you can see, it came out really well. So for now, I think the best use case would be these type of videos. Like I mentioned, there's not much change in terms of the quality compared to the native implementation. All right then, thank you for watching until the very end. Have a nice day ahead. Take care. Today for me is the 25th of December. So Merry Christmas to all of you. Happy holidays. Bye-bye now.